Oh, hey kids, today is Mother's Day. We get to honor our moms. That's right, Amazing Grace. I've been singing that song like crazy. Can't get it out of my head, you know, but I am so blessed and so grateful that my mom has given me grace at times when I needed it, times when I made a mistake. You know, God is the same way. He gives us grace. He loves us so much that when we make a mistake and we go to Him and we just ask for forgiveness, He gives us that grace, just like our moms do. Now, I gotta go find my mom. I've got this box of chocolates. Where did she go? I'm gonna go see my mom and I'm gonna honor her today. And you should do the same. But make sure it's after service. Then go honor your mom, because she deserves it, and God has given you a great mom.
As we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. We will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord, we will wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever.
Do not Dumb Kids, we have a new theme this month. It is going to be called A Maze of Grace. So the theme this whole month essentially is going to be talking about grace. Now I'd like to talk to you guys about rain. Let me open this up real quick. We don't hold back. It's pretty big. Woo! Woo! Okay, so it is raining cats and dogs outside today all week. I don't know where you guys are at, but here it's been raining so much and I don't think it's going to stop. It's spring. Rain is what we get. But there's something that's really great that happens when we get rain. After it rains, what do we get? I hope you guys said rainbow, because we get big, beautiful rainbows. But do you guys know what rainbows stand for? Rainbows stand for God's very first promise that talks about, I will never flood the earth again. It's kind of like, it's a reminder every time we see it of God's love and grace. So in the Bible, it talks about Noah, where there was a flood. God said, Noah, you need to build this gigantic boat. Side note, if you're able to go to Kentucky, there's something called the Creation Museum, and in the back they have the same exact measurements that God said in the Bible of the big ark, and it is amazing. I hope to see it soon. Anyways, back to the story. God said, Noah, I want you to build this giant boat. Then I'm going to bring to you two of every animal. Make sure you get all your family in there, close up the giant door that all the animals came in on, and then it's gonna rain and it's going to flood, but you guys are going to be safe. So the rainbow is God's promise that he'll never flood the earth again. Think about it, Noah's family, they're rocking back and forth. Rain is coming everywhere, they're on this boat. 40 days and nights, it rains. Oh, I am sure at the very end, when they saw the very first rainbow, I would be amazed, because rainbows look beautiful, especially if you see a double rainbow. Those are even cooler. Let's go to a scripture that is a great scripture in the Bible. It says, Deuteronomy 3:6, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or terrified because of them. For the Lord God goes with you. He will never forsake you. Let me go ahead and put this umbrella down, because this is pretty important. So, the word forsake. It's kind of a hard word. Not really something we say nowadays. Do you guys know what forsake means? That's pretty good. For those that don't know, forsake means either abandon or leave. So in the scripture, it's saying that you need to be strong and courageous. You have God on your side. He is never going to leave you or abandon you. He is always with you. And if God is with us, who can be against us? So there's another part in the Bible. We just had Easter, so this should be refreshed in your memory. Jesus died on the cross for our sins. So Jesus had to bear the sins of the world on his shoulders while he was on the cross. And he yelled out, God, why have you forsaken me? In Jesus's darkest, worst moment, I mean, he was inches away from death. He had been beaten, horrible things that happened to him, all so that we can go to heaven someday. So this is a hard moment for Jesus, and he feels like God has left him. Just like I'm sure all of us, when we have our really hard, tough moments, we feel like God has left us. But we know scripture is God breathed. Jesus and God are always going to be with us. So who can stand against us? Another thing I would like to bring up this Sunday as we close out, that it's Mother's Day, and that is a very important day, Mother's and Father's Day. You know, it does say in the Bible that you should honor your mother and your father, and it says that God will reward you with a long, happy life. So I think you guys should show your mothers just how very important they are to you. Maybe take some time today and make a card for her. Write down some nice words for her and tell her how much you love her. Do some things for her. You know, get her some water. If she likes to drink water, go ahead and give her the remote control and let her watch TV all day today, or put her feet up and you can rub her feet. Oh, I know, as a mom, I would love that. Whew. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great week. all week, you can go ahead and show your mom how much you love her and honor her. And if you have a tough moment, remember that God is always with you. I hope you guys have a great week. Bye.
After creation, after Adam and Eve, and after Cain and Abel, more people started to populate the earth. The more people there were, the worse things got. Adam and Eve had sinned, and now everyone was born sinful. People became wicked and evil, and soon forgot about God. There was at least one family who followed God's way: Noah, his wife, and their three sons. They were faithful to God. They served God. One day, God spoke to Noah and gave him an incredible task. God told Noah that he would punish the world because of its sin and send a great flood that would cover the entire earth. God told Noah that he would spare him and his family, and that Noah should build a big boat called an ark. God told them exactly how to make it. They were to leave room for themselves, as well as a lot of animals from all over the earth. They began construction on the ark right away. It was hard work. They had to do it all by themselves, and it was a huge boat, hundreds of feet long. The people thought Noah was crazy. They laughed and made fun of him. But Noah preached to them and told them to repent of their sins and obey God. The ark was almost done. As Noah and his sons put the finishing touches on it, the people continued in their wicked ways and paid no attention to God's warning. When the time came and the ark was complete, God sent two kinds of every animal in existence to the ark. That was incredible. Noah and his family, as well as all their animals, were to stay on this big boat until the flood was over. Two kinds of every animal had a place on the ark. Two by two, they got onto the ark. Giraffes, elephants, lions, kitty cats, turtles, worms, bears, birds, and everything else. And then the flood came. As the first sprinkles of rain splashed onto the ground, the people knew they were doomed. The ark's door was closed, and Noah and his family were safe. Huge fountains underneath the earth opened, and a torrent of rain gushed from the sky. Puddles grew into ponds. Streams formed into rivers. Rivers roared into the lakes. The lakes rose, connecting to form an ocean that covered the whole world. Everything was underwater. All the people who rejected God and made fun of Noah were dead. Only Noah's little family and his floating zoo were alive. They sailed on the vast ocean for many months as rain kept falling. Then the rain suddenly stopped. Noah sent out a bird to see if it could find a tree or some place to land, but the bird came back. Many days later, Noah sent out a dove. The dove returned with a leaf. This told Noah that the water had gone down and trees were starting to appear. Eventually, the ark came to rest on a mountainside. The flood was over. It was time to open the doors and let the animals out. As the doors opened, the birds fluttered out in freedom. The animals stepped onto the firm ground and went to find their way in the new world. Noah and his family stepped out and breathed a sigh of thankfulness to God. The first thing that Noah and his family did was to make an altar to God. They sacrificed to him and thanked him for protecting their family through the flood. God made a covenant with Noah. Then they saw it. A huge rainbow spread across the sky, painted in the most brilliant and beautiful colors that they had ever seen. It was a promise from God. A promise that he would never again curse the earth and destroy all living things with a flood.